In this final video of the signal series, we'll switch from using the RCS module to using the Virtual Robot Controller, or VRC, in iiQWorks.Sim. The goal is to simulate robot control using a virtual controller, connected to our existing Codesys project via OPC UA, the Open Platform Communication Unified Architecture. This setup allows us to simulate the robot's behavior in a virtual environment using the VRC, and everything you see here will work the same way on a real robot running iiQKA OS 2. You might recognize the setup from earlier videos. Our robot project includes a KUKA robot and four colored blocks. In the config dat, we've defined a 16-bit integer signal called colorNum. This signal is linked to 16 digital inputs, ranging from input 120 to input 135. In the main program, we use this signal inside a switch case statement to determine which block to handle. Here's how it works. First, we assign the tool and base that the robot should use. Then, we enter an endless loop and wait for a rising edge on input 119. Once the rising edge is detected, the program jumps into the switch case logic. Depending on the value of the colorNum signal, the robot executes the corresponding case, handles the correct block, and sets the appropriate output. In the first step, we'll establish the connection to our Codesys project. Activate the connectivity add-on in the options of iiQWorks.Sim and then click on the connectivity tab. This is the same project we used in the previous video, and we've already exported the I/O configuration from it. Now, we'll import that configuration into iiQWorks.Sim. To do that, go to the import section and select the exported file. Once imported, you'll see the OPC UA server address from existing Codesys project. In this case, it's running on localhost and using port 4845. Now, activate the connection. It may take a few seconds until the status turns green. Next, go to Connected Variables. Here, you can clearly see that the I/O mapping has been successfully imported. On the simulation to server side, you'll find all the outputs and robot access values. On the server to simulation side, you'll see all the inputs needed to control the robot. At this point, we're ready to start the simulation using the RCS module. Let's switch to the RCS module and start the simulation. You'll notice that the system is now waiting for a rising edge on input 119. Let's now trigger the robot behavior in our Codesys simulation. First, we resize the simulation window to make things easier to see. Now, we'll manually trigger the signal. We set the trigger byte to true, which simulates a rising edge. Then we set the colorNum signal to 0, which corresponds to the green block. As expected, the robot enters the switch case logic, sets output 106, and handles the green block. Everything works as intended. Next, we reset the trigger byte to false and switch from the RCS module to the Virtual Robot Controller, or VRC. To do that, open the simulation configuration or go to the KRL executors of the component properties. There, select VRC as the execution mode. Make sure your VRC is running locally on your computer. Select the correct instance. You can tick the box, Start iiQKA UI, to launch the web UI when starting the simulation. But this will only work if you have the corresponding option package assigned to your robot. If everything looks good, start the simulation. Now the simulation is running with the VRC, and the web UI shows the robot setup. We're again waiting for a rising edge on input 119. Let's trigger it manually. We set input 119 to true in the Codesys simulation. In the connectivity tab, this input 119 also reaches the connected variables on the iiQWorks.Sim side and is displayed as true. But when we check the web UI, input 119 still shows as false. This means additional steps are needed to ensure the signal reaches the VRC correctly. Just like with a real robot, you need to connect the input and output signals to the robot using appropriate I/O modules. Let's start by adding a digital I/O board to the robot. In this example, we'll use the KUKA system bus, which already includes a digital I/O board with 16 input bits and 16 output bits. Since our signal colorNum requires 16 input bits, we need to expand the configuration. To do that, open the I/O mapping editor and select the robot on both sides of the mapping. Now, navigate to the system bus section. You'll see the existing digital inputs and outputs. As you can see, the current board provides 16 input bits and 16 output bits. That's not enough if we want to use all 16 bits for our integer signal. So let's add an additional I/O module. In the devices tree, right-click on the KUKA system bus and then click on Add and choose the EIOB module, which provides extra input and output capacity. Once added, you'll see the new module appear in the system configuration. This ensures that all required signals are properly connected and available for the VRC to process during simulation. Now let's open the I/O mapping editor again to check our configuration. You'll see that we've added two I/O modules, each providing 16 input bits and 16 output bits. These modules can now be connected to the robot's inputs and outputs that we need for the simulation. On the input side, we need input 119 for the trigger signal, and inputs 120 to 135 for the integer signal color num. Additionally, to transfer the gripper position signals to the VRC, we also need inputs 101 and 102. Let's start by selecting the digital inputs from the first module. We'll mark all 16 inputs and assign them to the robot. These inputs will be used for the color num signal, which controls which block the robot should handle. Next, we move to the second module and assign inputs 101 and 102 for the gripper's end position signals. Finally, we assign input 119 for the trigger signal. Once all inputs are mapped, you'll see that the robot is now fully connected to the required signals. This setup ensures that the VRC receives all necessary inputs to simulate the robot behavior accurately. At first, the mapping didn't work correctly. That's usually a sign that the connection wasn't fully established. So we double-checked the inputs 101 and 102. And after retrying, the mapping was successful. You can now see the blue symbol indicating that the signals are correctly connected. Next, we continue with the output mapping. We open the digital output section and select 6 outputs, because we need exactly 6 for our simulation. Inputs 101 and 102 are used to control the gripper, and outputs 103 to 106 are used in our switch case logic to handle the colored blocks. Once selected, we wait a moment for the system to confirm the mapping. Again, the blue symbol confirms that the outputs are now connected. Now we can close the mapping editor and restart the simulation. With the VRC running in the background, the simulation is launched again. This may take a few seconds. Everything looks good so far. Back in iiQWorks.Sim, we notice that something already happened, most likely because input 119 was still set to true. So we go back into the Codesys settings and reset input 119 to false. Now let's test the signal behavior in the simulation. We want the robot to pick the blue block, so we set input integer value of color num to 10 and the input 119 to true. This triggers the robot to act. Next, we open the web UI of the VRC. In the I/O section, we check input 119 and confirm that it's currently true. To test further, we force input 119 to false and change the value of our integer signal from 10 to 20. This updates the corresponding inputs, and we can see the change reflected in the web UI. Now we set input 119 back to true. The robot responds by picking the yellow block, and the correct output is activated. This confirms that the I/O mapping is working as expected. The method we used here is one way to connect the robot's inputs and outputs. But there are alternatives. For example, you can add a KUKA extension bus and include an additional I/O module. This gives you 16 input bits and 16 output bits, just like the I/O module. You can also use Profinet. To do that, add the corresponding options package and configure the field bus settings. Select Profinet and set up the connection. Finally, you can export and import your bus configuration. You can choose to export just the I/O mapping or the entire project configuration. To export, go to the Import/Export section and select Export I/O Mappings. Choose the bus system you want to export, like the KUKA system bus, and save the file. Later, you can import it again using Import I/O Mappings. This works just like the Import/Export feature in the connectivity add-on and helps you reuse configurations across projects. In this tutorial, you learned how to simulate a robot project using the Virtual Robot Controller, VRC, in iiQWorks.Sim, connected to a Codesys project via OPC UA. You configured and mapped all necessary inputs and outputs, including trigger signals, gripper positions, and block identifiers, using digital I/O modules and verified their behavior in the iiQKA web UI.
Thank you for watching. We hope you find this video tutorial helpful. Don't forget to follow the KUKA channel for more updates and more exciting content. If you're looking for hands-on training, visit the KUKA College to enhance your skills. See you in the next video.
Making automation easier.